All right, this is, here we go. Now we're online. Okay, so I got the iPad today. Might look a little bit different. I'm here in Nelson, Hamby Park. It's a beautiful day. We're looking at hot and cold. This is a kind of this hot thermal energy, and cold is not so much energy. Hope you guys are having fun in your lockdown. We've got Einstein here just to say hello.
Ka-chah! Hi, everybody. This is having so much fun. I want to see who I can see. Cass is there, and iMac, and Ruben, and Eden. Hello. Debbie, and Dylan, and Michaela, and Noah, Flory, Poppy. There's lots of people. Lots of people there. It's good. Thanks for coming. This is a little experiment you can do at home. All it takes is a bottle. This is like a little energy drink bottle. I was just in Japan a little while ago. Got one of those. And I'll show you what we're going to look at today. It's about hot air and cold air. Okay, we're going to looking at how they work, what happens to hot air, what happens to cold air. This is some of the things we've talked about before, and then with balloons, and we'll look see how that affects the weather. And at the same time, you can think about predictions, observations, and experimentation. So that's kind of the sciencey stuff we're going to be looking at today. So I've got this set up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move you over to the hot and the cold area. There we go. I'm going to switch you around. All right. So I've got a couple of bowls here. One's pretty hot and one's pretty cold. I'm just going to put the thermometers in there to see what's going on. Right, and there's a thermometer. Oh, it's about 18 in my house. Oh, it's gone up to 52. We'll see what that one does. Takes a minute for the thermometers to get going. So it's 20 degrees in my house. So we have hot and then we have cold. So this one's looking at 6 degrees, 6.9 at the moment. And this one is about 52. Okay. So then, come back to me. What I'm doing, so I've got this little bottle, and I tried lots of different bottles, and I tried plastic bottles and glass bottles, and the smaller one works well, because what we're going to do is if you look in there, there's some stuff left over, there's nothing in there, but actually there is something in there, there's just air. Okay, so if you shake it around, you could say, oh, there's nothing in there, but there's actually air in there. So what I'm going to do is put a balloon on top. So this will work with any bottle and any balloon. So when we put this in the cold, I'll put it in the I'll put it switched around. So I'm just going to put this in the hot. And what's happening? We're just heating up the air that's in this little metal bottle, and the hot air will heat up there and then inflate the balloon. It's taking its time. So it heats the air in the bottom. We might have a little leakage. All right, I'll cool it off first. All right, so see how it kind of sucks it in. Oh, that was pretty cool. All right, and then we put it in the hot. Blows it up. I think the air is pretty hot in there already. Oh yeah, there it goes. Heating the air. Should blow the balloon right up. All right, well, watch it when we suck it in. It kind of sucks the whole balloon in there, and then when we do it like this, blows it out. I'll try it again. Try a different balloon. Balloon going.
It should just stand up like that. I made it. Okay, so it's standing up. And then you put it in the cold. It goes down. You just have to try and experiment with this one. And then when you put it in the hot, it goes up. I'm going to try a little bit more hot. All right, I'll go on to the show you how this works with weather. So this is how this kind of works in your so this is how hot air balloons work. So if you're going to look at a hot air balloon, and when you heat the air in one of those little baskets, got a big burner, fills a hot air balloon with air, hot air, and then it floats up. I've got one of those. I've got a little one. I can show you in a minute. And what was the other one that we had? That one. All right. So this is kind of cool, hot air balloon stuff. And it also affects the weather. I'm gonna try this one one more time. A little bit more hot water in there. Blow that one up. Oh yeah, that works better. It works better with a bit filling up the with a little bit more hot water in there, and then you put it down, put it in the cold, it goes down, put it in the hot, it goes. Okay, so that's working. It just needed a little bit more hot water in there. Cold water, the air in there shrinks and gets smaller. When you do the hot water, the air becomes less dense and fills up the balloon. It wants to rise and take up more space. All right, and how this works in, this is what drives our weather systems. Oh, here's one other thing. They're doing these weather balloons down in Wanaka. NASA hires this balloon firm down in Wanaka to shoot up these weather balloons that go straight up almost to the, almost to space, and they take photos and they take kind of readings, scientific stuff, and how it works with weather. So when you look at cold air is denser, so it stays close to the ground, and then warm air goes up, and as the cold air moves along the ground, it like kind of makes the rain. When the warm air and the cold air come together, that creates rain, it creates clouds, and that's how a lot of the weather systems work in around the world. All right, okay, so now we're gonna go outside, it's a beautiful day, got a hot air balloon, and after this is gonna go flying up in the air, and then we're gonna cut the camera. Oh yeah, I just wanna show this again, what we've been doing today. It was all about the hot air and the cold air. We're looking at predictions. We're going to make sure we think balloon, and we're going to think about why did that happen. Okay. We're going to go outside now. All right. So let's switch the camera around. I need my cameraman is going to grab this. You can follow me.
Hopefully the Wi-Fi comes up.
Can you see me?
All right, so you can go over by that hedge. I'll run out. You can talk to him in a second. You can show him the weather, the clouds. Are there any clouds today? Come a little closer, can you see? So I got plenty of hot air. Are you ready? All right. Got it? Blowing away. Okay. Thanks, you guys. That was it. See you guys later. End the meeting.